We're on. Welcome to our Easter celebration or Resurrection Day celebration here. Christ is risen.
He is risen indeed.
Bethel is an inclusive faith community seeking to transform lives by exemplifying the unconditional love of Jesus. We extend a cordial and heartfelt welcome to all who join us in worship today in person via Zoom. Welcome to those new to the Christian faith, those who are longtime followers of Christ, as well as those who are just curious about faith. To our friends who are without a church home and those visiting with friends and family from another faith community, to those who need strength, want to follow Jesus Christ, have doubts, or do not yet believe, to people of every color, culture, sexual orientation, gender identification, economic background, age, size, ability, and challenge, old friends or new guests, to the old and the young, believers and questioners, and questioning believers, we welcome you to worship God with us today.
Amen.
Today we will have a special presentation, The Cry of the Whole Congregation, an original piece written by Walter
Wonger.
And throughout our script, you may notice that today's doesn't really conform to the male-female roles. So we feel that we need to say our script for today conforms to binary views and points about gender sometimes in when we ask for men to say or women to say. But we invite you to speak at those points that you feel comfortable. We're invited into the drama of Holy Week. There is no audience. We are the cast. We watch, we listen, we speak, we sing, we feel. In the space of a week, we see celebration change into tragedy. We can't stop it. We are forced to remember that the joy of the resurrection comes only after the agony of the crucifixion. We're led by four narrators, dancers, drummers, and musicians. The narrator tells the story and speaks the words of Jesus. The other three assume the roles of Judas, the unrepentant criminal, Peter, the repentant criminal, and Pilate, the Pharisee. Let us enter into the story. Let us never forget.
The next day, the great crowd had come for the festival, heard that Jesus was on his way to Jerusalem. They took palm branches and went out to meet him, shouting, "Hosanna! Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord! Blessed is the King of Israel!"
Shouting, they come just to see their King. Tell the daughter of Zion to rejoice, rejoice, for we've been redeemed.
He's riding victorious like the prophets foretold. Visions are glorious.
We must bow down before him, lay our hearts and souls before him, Lord of all. Hearts and souls before him, Lord of all, Lord of all. Hosanna,
The same mind be in you that was in Christ Jesus, who thought he was in the form, though he was in the form of God, did not regard equality with God as something to be exploited. And being found in human form, he humbled himself and became obedient to the point of death, even death on the cross.
Exalted him and gave him the name that is above every name,
so that at the name of Jesus every knee should bow in heaven and on earth and under the earth,
and every tongue should confess that Jesus Christ is Lord, to the glory of God the Father.
I see the King of glory coming on the clouds with fire. The whole earth shakes, the whole earth shakes. I see his love and mercy washing over all our sin. The people sing, the people sing. Hosanna! Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest. Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest.
I see a generation rising up to take their place with selfless faith. I see a near revival stirring as we pray and seek. We're on our knees, we're on our knees.
Hosanna, Hosanna.
Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna.
When Jesus drew near to Bethage and Bethany, at the mount that is called Olivet, he sent ahead two of his disciples, saying, "Go into the village opposite. There you will find a colt tied, on which no one has ever sat. Untie it and bring it here. If anyone asks you, 'Why are you untying it?' you shall say, 'The Lord has need of it.'" So those who were sent away found as it was told them.
And as they were untying the colt, its owner said to them, "Why are you untying the colt?"
And they said, "The Lord has need of it." And they brought it to Jesus, and throwing their garments on the colt, they set Jesus upon it.
As he rode along, they spread their garments on the road. And as he was drawing near at the descent of the Mount of Olives, the whole multitudes of the disciples began to rejoice and to praise God in a loud voice for all the mighty works that they had seen, saying,
"Let the glory of the Lord rise among us. Let the glory of the Lord rise among us. Let the glory of the Lord rise among us. Let it rise.
Let the song of the Lord, the song of our Lord,
rise among us. Let the song of the Lord rise among us. Let the joy of
and the multitude cried to him, "Teacher, rebuke your disciples. They're calling you the Christ. Tell them to shut up."
He answered, "I tell you, if these were silent, the very stones themselves would cry out."
The Lord rise among us.
City, he wept over it, saying, "Would that even today you knew the things that make for peace, but now they are hid from your eyes. Oh, Jerusalem, the days shall come upon you when your enemies will cast up a bank about you and surround you and hem you on every side and dash you to the ground, you and your children within you, and they will not leave one stone upon another in you, because you did not know the time of your visitation." Now the Feast of the Unleavened Bread drew near, which is called Passover, and the temple priests were seeking how to put Jesus to death, for they feared the people.
Then Satan entered into Judas, called Iscariot, who was of the number of the 12. He went away and conferred with the temple priests and officers how he might betray him to them. And they were glad and engaged to give him money. So he agreed and sought an opportunity to betray him, to them in the absence of the multitude.
Then came the day of the unleavened bread, on which the Passover lamb had to be sacrificed. So Jesus sent Peter and John, saying, "Go and prepare the Passover for us, that we may eat."
They said to him, "But where, Lord? Where will you have us prepare it? And what are we to do?"
He said to them, "Behold, when you have entered the city, a man carrying a jar of water will meet you. Follow him into the house which he enters, and tell the householder, 'The teacher says to you, where is the guest room where I am to eat the Passover with my disciples?' And he will show you a large upper room furnished. There, make ready." And they went and found it as he had told them. And they prepared the Passover. And when the hour came, he sat at table and the apostles with him. And he said to them, "I have earnestly desired to eat this Passover with you before I suffer. For I tell you, I shall not eat it until it is fulfilled in the kingdom of God." Jesus said to the disciples, "Behold, the hand of the man who betrays me is with me on table. For the Son of Man goes as it has been determined. But woe to that man by whom he is betrayed."
And they began to question, "Who, Lord? Who is to betray you? Is it I? Is it I?"
He answered, "He who has dipped his hand in the dish with me will betray me. Oh, it would have been better for that man if he had not been born."
Judas, who betrayed him, said, "Is it I, Master?"
Jesus said to him, "You have said so."
Simon Peter was indignant, "But not I," he said, and he declared, "Though they all fall away from you, I will never leave you."
"Peter, truly I say to you, this very night, before the cock crows, you will deny me three times."
Peter said to him, "Even if I must die with you, I will never deny you."
And so said all the disciples, over and over again.
A breath, you breathe your life in me. You have been so, so kind to me, and
never ending breath.
No shadow you won't light up, mountain you won't climb up, coming after me, yeah. There's no wall you won't kick down, thigh you won't tear down, coming after me, yeah. Oh. There's no shadow you won't light up, mountain you won't climb up, coming after me,
yeah.
There's no wall you won't kick down, thigh you won't tear down, coming after me. Coming after me, oh.
Came out and went as was his custom to the Mount of Olives. And the disciples followed him. And when he came to the place, he said to them, pray. Pray that you may not enter into temptation.
Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
And he withdrew from them about a stone's throw and knelt down and prayed, Father, if thou art willing, remove this cup from me. Nevertheless, not my will, but thine be done.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done. Thy will be done.
And he went,
thy will be done.
And when he rose from prayer, he came to the disciples and found them sleeping for sorrow. And he said to them, why do you sleep? Rise and pray that you may not enter into temptation.
Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil, even evils within ourselves.
While he was still speaking, there came a crowd, and the man called Judas, one of the 12, was leading them. He drew near to Jesus to kiss him.
But Jesus said to him, Judas, would you betray the Son of Man with a kiss?
And Judas said, Hail, Master.
When the disciples saw what would follow, they said, Lord, shall we strike with the sword?
And one of them struck the slave of the high priest and cut off his right ear.
But Jesus said no more of this, and he touched his ear and healed him.
Forgive us our trespasses.
Jesus said to those who had come out against him, when I was with you day after day in the temple, you did not lay hands on me, but this is your hour and the power of darkness.
Yeah.
They seized him and led him away, bringing him to the high priest's house.
Peter followed at a distance, and when they had kindled a fire in the middle of the courtyard and had sat down together, Peter sat among them.
Then amazed, seeing him in the light, said, "This man also was with him."
But he denied it, saying, "Woman, I do not know him."
And a little later, someone else
said to him,
But Peter said, "Man, I am not."
An hour later, another insisted, saying, "Certainly this man also was with him, for he is Galilean."
But Peter said, "Man, I do not know what you are saying."
And immediately, while he was still speaking, the cock crowed, and the Lord turned and looked at Peter.
And Peter remembered the word of the Lord, how he had said to him, "Before the cock crows today, you will deny me three times." And he went out and he wept bitterly.
Now the men who were holding Jesus mocked him and beat him. They blindfolded him and demanded,
"Prophesy, who is it that struck you?"
And they spoke many more words against him, reviling him. When the day came, the assembly of elders of the people gathered together and led him to their council.
And they said, "If you are the Christ, tell us."
But he said to them, "If I tell you, you will not believe. And if I ask you now, you will not answer. But from now on, the Son of Man shall be seated at the right hand of the power of God."
And they said, "Are you the Son of God then?"
And he said to them, "You say that I am." Then the company of them arose and brought him to Pontius Pilate.
And they began to curse him, saying, "We found this man perverting our nation and forbidding us to give tribute to Caesar, and saying that he himself is the Christ the King."
And Pilate asked him, "Are you the King of the Jews?"
And he answered him, "You have said so."
And Pilate said to the chief priests and the multitudes, "I find no crime in this man."
But they were urgent, saying, "He stirs up the people, teaching throughout Galilee, even to this place."
And when Pilate heard that he was a Galilean of Herod's jurisdiction, he sent him to Herod.
For he was vehemently accused and treated with contempt and mocked and arrayed in gorgeous purple, and then sent back again.
Pilate said to the rulers of the people, "You brought me this man as one who was perverting the people. And after examining him, behold, I did not find him guilty of any of the charges against him. Behold, nothing deserving death has been done by him. I will therefore chastise him and release him."
Barabbas, a man who had been thrown in prison for insurrection and for murder.
Pilate addressed them once more, desiring to release Jesus.
But they shouted out, "Crucify him! Crucify him!"
"Why? What evil has he done? I found no crime in him deserving death. I'll chastise him. I'll release him."
But they are urgent, demanding with loud cries that he shall be crucified.
And their voices prevailed.
So Pilate gave sentence that their demand should be granted. He released the man who had been jailed for murder, but Jesus he delivered up to their will.
Calvary's mournful mountain climb, there adoring at his feet, mark that miracle of time, God's own sacrifice complete. It is finished, hear him cry. Learn from Jesus Christ to die.
But Jesus, he delivered over to their will.
And as they led him away, they seized one of Simon of Cyrene, who was coming in from the country, and laid on him the cross to carry her behind Jesus. And there followed him a great multitude of women who bewailed and lamented him.
But Jesus, turning to them, said, "Daughters of Jerusalem, do not weep for me, but weep for yourselves and for your children. For behold, the days are coming when they will say, 'Blessed are the barren, and the wombs that never bore, and the breasts that never gave suck.' For if they do this when the wood is green, what will happen when it dries?"
To tremble, tremble, tremble. Were you there when they crucified my Lord?
Two others also who were criminals were led away to be put to death with him. When they came to the place which is called the Skull, there they crucified him and the criminals, one on the left and one on the right.
Were you there when they nailed him to the cross? Were you there when they nailed him to the tree? Sometimes it causes me to tremble, tremble, tremble. Were you there when they nailed him to the tree?
And Jesus said, "Father, forgive them, for they know not what they do."
Forgive us our trespasses. And they cast lots to divide his garments. Forgive us our trespasses. And the people stood by watching, but the rulers scoffed at him, saying, "He saved others. Let him save himself,
if he is the Christ of God. Forgive us our trespasses. The soldiers also mocked him, coming up and offering him vinegar. There was an inscription over him: "This is the King of the Jews." Forgive us our trespasses. Forgive us, O Lord, our trespasses.
One of the criminals who were hung with him railed at him, saying, "Are you the Christ? Save yourself and us."
But the other rebuked him, saying, "Do you not fear God, since you are under the same sentence, and we justly? But this man has done nothing wrong." And he said, "Jesus, remember me when you come into your kingdom."
Forgive us our trespasses. Deliver us from evil. Thine is the kingdom.
And Jesus said to him,
"And the power.
Truly, truly, I say to you,
and the glory.
Today you will be with me in paradise.
Forever and ever. Amen."
Were you there when he cried out at the end? Were you there when he cried out at the end? Oh, sometimes it causes me to tremble, tremble, tremble. Were you there when he cried out at the end?
It was now about the sixth hour, and there was darkness over the land until the ninth hour, when the sun's light failed. And the curtain of the temple was torn in two from the top to the bottom. Then Jesus cried with a loud voice, saying, "Father, into your hands do I commend my spirit." And having said this, he breathed his last. And all the multitudes who had assembled to see the sight,
when they saw what had taken place, they returned home, beating their breasts. And all his acquaintances and the women who had followed him from Galilee stood at a distance and saw these things.
Oh,
One looking for the kingdom of God. This man went to Pilate and asked for the body of Jesus. Then he took it down and wrapped it in a linen shroud and laid him in a rock-hewn tomb where no one had ever yet been laid.
After the Sabbath, at dawn of the first day of the week, Mary Magdalene and the other Mary went to look at the tomb. There was a violent earthquake. For an angel of the Lord came down from heaven and going to the tomb, rolled back the stone and sat on it. His appearance was like lightning and his clothes were white as snow. The guards were so afraid of him that they shook and became like dead men. The angel said to the women, Afraid, for I know that you are looking for Jesus who was crucified. He is not here. He has risen. He has risen just as he said. Drive the nails in my hands, laugh at me where you stand. And go ahead and say it isn't me. The day will come when you will see, 'cause I'll my love for you is still the same. Go ahead and bury me, but very soon you will see, 'cause I'll dead and gone, but you will see that you were wrong. And go ahead and try to hide the sun, but all will see that I'm the one, 'cause I'll
gracious God, we come today and we thank you that in those Fridays in our life, when dreams and hopes die, and in the Saturdays when we're waiting hopelessly, helplessly, that the promise of Scripture is that there is a Sunday that gives us a new hope, that we will indeed rise again. Thank you, Jesus, that no one made you give your life, but you willingly laid it down as an example for us of what true love is. Thank you, God, for the resurrection power that you give each of us every day. And may that resurrection power transform how we live life each moment of the day moving forward. In God's holy name we pray. Amen.
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 Would everyone sing along with us on the next song?
Every praise.
Every praise.
We call it a script because you're all dancing.
To love and serve the Lord God and one another, please join us in food and fellowship. Thank you, everybody. And also, thank you so much to the Lawrence family and to Davey and Marcos, everybody, and all of our soloists, all part of our church. What a great Bethel family. Praise God.